Good morning, students. How are you all? Children, yesterday I have sent you a video on junk seller part 1, and in that part I have taught you about what the junk seller is. Okay? And I've taught you about loan. The term of loan is what? That meaning I have taught you that loan is borrowing money from bank or some institution. Okay? And even I've taught you about Indian currencies, rupees and paisa. Okay? So now today, open your maths textbook page number 62 and let's begin. Here Kiran says, people laughed and teased us about our work. They called it ganda kaam or dirty business. But I did not think so. I knew this idea would work. So Kiran was a junk seller, and she is a junk seller actually. But the people, they tease her. Why? Because she is collecting junk from everyone. So junk is very dirty, and the business is dirty business, people thought about it. But Kiran did not think so, and she continued working hard. Okay. Now we have a pakka house with electricity. We have a fridge, a TV and a gas stove. My husband's brother's sister and also my daughter go to school, says Kiran. You have seen in earlier video, previous video, that when Kiran got married, her husband was living in mud house. Okay. So after joining this business or after starting this business, now Kiran is having a pakka house. She is having fridge, TV, gas stove, and her husband's brother and sister and also her daughter, they go to school. Now she says, I have 9 rickshaws of my own. I give the rickshaws on rent, each for rupees 20 a day. On Sundays, I do not take any money for them. Children, this is called rickshaw. This is paddle rickshaw. Okay. So what we do? What she do? She gave the rickshaws on rent. Rent means she gives it to someone, and he works. And when he will return, he or she will return, they will give money also. That is called rent. They will use, but they may not. They cannot own it. They have to return it and they have to pay the money for it. Okay. So she gave the rickshaws on rent, each for rupees 20 a day. On Sundays, she don't take any money for them. Now, how much does Kiran earn from 9 rickshaws in a day? For one rickshaw, she gets rupees 20 per day. So for 9 rickshaws, she will earn rupees 20 multiplied by 9, because number of rickshaws are 9. So 20 multiplied by 9. So here we will do 2 nines are 2 multiplied by 9. So 2 nines are is 18, and the 0 which is after 2 will keep it after 18. So it will become rupees 180. Now here, hey, I will do it like this. 9 times 2 is 18. So 9 times 20 is 180. Here can you see? A 9 times 2, 18. Now here after 2, they added 10. So after 18, they have added 102. So 9 times 20 is 180. Now this ended saying, but I find this easier. For 10 rickshaws, she will get rupees 20 multiplied by 10 is equal to 200. Okay. What we are asked for 9 rickshaws. But what she did calculate it, she calculated it for 10 rickshaws. For 10 rickshaws, she paid 200 rupees. So for 9 rickshaws, she will get rupees 200 minus 20. Why minus 20? Because she subtracted money for one rickshaw. 20 rupees per day. So 200 minus 20 is equal to rupees 180. The both answers are same. Okay. Now think of some other way to do it. You do it. Okay. Now next is, do it mentally and write the answers. 2 6 are, we know it is 12. 26 are, you know 2 6 are 12. And put 1 0 of this after 20 wala. You just keep after 12. So it will become 120. Now 2 60s are the same way. 2 6 are 12. And put this 0 of 60 after 12. So it will be 120. Now 3 multiply by 42. 4 multiply by 8. 4 multiply by 81. 9 multiply by 25. And 31 multiply by 9. Let's see another. To solve this, we will use distributive property of multiplication. That is, for 3 multiply by 42, what we will do? 42 is equal to 40 plus 2. We will write it in expanded form. 40 plus 2 is equal to 42. So 3 multiply by 42 is equal to 3 multiply by, instead of 42, we will write 40 plus 2. Okay. Now 3 multiply by 40, we will write over here. And then this sign of plus will put in between. And now 3 multiply by 2, we will write over here. Okay. We don't know the table of 40, but we know the table of 4. So 3 4s are 12, we can write. And put 1 0 of 40 over here. So 3 multiply by 40 is equal to 120 plus 3 2s are 6. So the answer will be 126. The same here, 81, we'll write it in expanded form is 80 plus 1. Okay. So 4 multiply by 81 is equal to 4 multiply by 80 plus 1. Instead of 81, we have written 80 plus 1. So 4 multiply by 80 plus 4 multiply by 1. So 4 8s are 32 and we'll put 0 over here. So it will become 320. So 4 multiply by 80 is equal to 320 plus 4 multiply by 1 is equal to 4. So addition of 320 plus 4 is 324. Now again, next is 25 is equal to 20 plus 5. So 9 multiply by 25 is equal to 9 multiply by, instead of 25, what we will write? 20 plus 5. So 9 multiply by 20 plus 9 multiply by 5. 9 multiply by 20. 29 is a 180 plus 9 5 is a 45. So it will become 225. Now 31. So 31 is equal to 30 plus 1. So 9 multiply by 31 is equal to 9 multiply by, instead of 31, we will write 30 plus 1. 9 multiply by 30 plus 9 multiply by 1. So 9 30s are, we don't know, but 9 3s are, we know. 9 3s are 27. Put 0 over here. So it will become 270 plus 9 1s are 9. So it will become 279. Okay. So now as we have seen, 2 6s are 12, 26 are 120, 2 60s are 120, 3 multiplied by 42 is 126. Now 4 80s are, we don't know 80s, table of 80, but we know the table of 4. 4 8s are 32 and we'll put 0 over there. So 320 will be the answer. 4 multiplied by 81, as I have shown you, it is 324. Now what this AND is saying, 4 multiplied by 81 is 4 more than 4 multiplied by 80. Yes, children. 4 multiplied by 80 is 320. And 4 multiplied by 81 is equal to 324. So 320 is here and 324 is here. So 4 is more. Okay. So she is, the AND is correct. 9 multiplied by 25. Answer is 225. 31 multiplied by 9. The answer is 279. Now, Kiran says, I have my own small junk shop. I buy junk from junk collectors. They go from house to house and bring junk on hand carts. I then sell it at the big shop. Children, as you have seen in previous video, she is having a junk shop and she is buying junk from the junk collectors. Okay, and she sell whole junk at the big shop and she earns money out of it. How much to pay for this junk? Kiran has bought some junk from junk collectors. Look at the next page, the rate list, to see today's rates. Help Kiran to find out the cost of the junk. How much will Kiran pay for 31 kilogram of newspaper? Here, 1 kilogram of newspaper's cost is given. So 1 kg newspaper cost rupees 5. The 30 kg cost rupees 5 multiplied by 30. This is unitary method. So 5 multiplied by 30 is 150 rupees. Because 5 threes are 50 and 0 we will put. So it will become 150 rupees. Okay. So for 31 kg, she pays how much? The same way, by unitary method also we can do. The answer is 155. Let's see how. Let's discuss. 1 kg newspaper cost rupees 5. So 31 kg of newspaper's cost is rupees 5 multiplied by 31. So it will become rupees 155. How come? 5 ones are 5 and 5 threes are 50. So it will become 155 rupees. Now let's see rate list. Kind of junk and price of 1 kilogram is given. Okay, kind of junk is also given, like waste paper rupees 7, newspaper is for rupees 15, iron is for rupees 22, brass is for rupees 270 and plastic is for rupees 10. How much will Kiran pay for 42 kilogram newspaper? Also find the cost of 22 kg of plastic, 23 kg of waste paper and 12 kg of iron. And you have to guess the total money Kiran will pay to the junk collectors. Will it be more than 600 or less than 600? These things we have to calculate and then we will guess. Okay. So cost of 1 kg of newspaper is rupees 15. Cost of 40 kg of newspaper is equal to rupees 15 multiplied by 42. By using distributive property of multiplication, we will solve it. 15 multiplied by 42. For 42, we will write it in the expanded form, 40 plus 2. Okay. So first of all, cost of 42 kilogram of newspaper is rupees 15 multiplied by 42. Rupees 15 multiplied by, instead of 42, we will write this 40 plus 2. See, here we have written, instead of 42, what we have written? 40 plus 2. Now, here 15 multiplied by 40 plus 15 multiplied by 2. See, we have written like this. Now, we don't know 15 40s are, but we know 15 4s are. 15 4s are is 60. And this 0 from 40, we will keep it, put it here. So, 15 multiplied by 40 is rupees 600 plus 15 multiplied by 2 is 30. So 600 plus 30 is rupees 630. So answer is Kiran will pay rupees 630 for 42 kilogram of newspaper. Now find the cost of 23 kilogram of waste paper. Cost of 1 kilogram waste paper is rupees 7. So cost of 23 kilogram waste paper is equal to 7 multiplied by 23. But for 23, we will write it in expanded form, 20 plus 3. Okay. So cost of 23 kilogram waste paper is equal to 7 multiplied by 23. Instead of 23, we will write 20 plus 3. Now 7 multiplied by 20 plus 7 multiplied by 3. So 7 multiplied by 20 is 140 and 7 multiplied by 3 is 21. So 140 plus 21 is equal to 161. The answer is K Kiran will pay 161 rupees for 23 kilogram of waste paper. Now rate list we have seen. Now let us write how much will Kiran pay for 42 kg newspaper. She will pay 630, okay, for 42 kg newspaper. Also find the cost of 22 kg of plastic. So rupees 10, 22 of the plastic is, rate of the plastic is rupees 10. So 10 multiplied by 22 is rupees 220. Now 23 kg of waste paper, rupees 7 multiplied by 23. So 7 multiplied by 23 is 161. Now 12 kg of iron. 12 kg of iron is rupees 22 multiplied by 12 is equal to 264. Okay. So when we will add up this all amount, we will get 1275 rupees. This amount, 1275 rupees, Kiran has to pay to junk collectors. Okay. So guess the total money Kiran will pay the junk collectors. It will be 1275 rupees. So will it be more than 600 or less than 600? Definitely it will be more than 600. I hope all of you understood this. The distributive property, unitary method of multiplication. Okay. So keep practicing and thank you for the video.